Masayoshi-san is one of the most influential deal makers of our time.
This is Masa of SoftBank from Japan.
Son, who goes by Masa, is considered by some as one of the most brilliant risk takers in venture capital. $32 billion for chipmaker Arm, $9 billion to Uber, $4.4 billion into WeWork. The list goes on. Others think the chief executive of SoftBank is a reckless daredevil with a spotty track record. After the dot-com crash, he lost more money than anyone has ever lost in history, $70 billion.
We almost went bankrupt. And somehow I survived.
But love him or hate him, he's shaking up Silicon Valley and global investing. Has Masa just been lucky, or is he actually a genius when it comes to investing in the future of technology? So, is he a genius investor?
I think the jury is still out, but one thing you cannot deny, Son, is that, you know, he certainly seems to have foresight.
Bloomberg tech reporter Pavel Olpiev has been covering Masa and SoftBank for the last decade.
One famous example is a few years prior to Apple's launch of the iPhone, Son was visiting with Steve Jobs in California and offered him sketches of a prototype device that combines functionalities of the iPod and a mobile phone.
Knowing Apple was developing the iPhone, Jobs refused. So Masa got him to agree to exclusive rights for their product in Japan, bringing SoftBank and Masa a lot of success. This wasn't his first big business deal, however. While attending the University of California at Berkeley, he invented a digital translator and sold it to Sharp for 100 million yen, or about $1 million. Using that money, he founded SoftBank, which is a household name in Japan and airs popular commercials with Tommy Lee Jones and a dog. For a brief period during the dot-com bubble, Masa was the world's richest man before 99% of his deals failed. At the center of his reputation is one very important transaction. In 2000, he made a $20 million investment in an unknown Chinese startup called Alibaba and a young founder named Jack Ma.
I could tell from the way he talked, the way he looked at, he has a charisma, he has a leadership.
SoftBank's stake in Alibaba is now worth $138 billion, one of the most lucrative venture investments of all time.
One could potentially be lucky. So if you assume that a track record of one is just lucky, then it certainly casts doubt on Son's ability to pick winners.
Nowadays, Masa is aggressively making investments on a massive scale in tech. He invested in 100 or so startups in 2017, including two of the most valuable, Uber and Didi. With both, he uses a similar maneuver to close the deal.
Son went publicly on record saying that the company is considering investing in Uber or Lyft, you know, a not so subtle hint at take the money or we'll find somebody else who will.
Masa has a distinctive deal-making style. He's known to invite founders to Tokyo for a formal meeting, followed by a meal, and then offer them a massive amount of money.
And the picture that we get is that when Son comes into the room, at this point, his business people know your company through and through, and he's there to make an offer.
Although he doesn't acquire controlling stakes in any of the companies and is generally hands-off, SoftBank's money still comes with one important condition.
Like he told San Diego-based robot company Brain Corp. Basically, he wants them to reach their goal at an accelerated rate.
As Masa pours money into one startup after another, he's also been lining up some generous backers for SoftBank's $100 billion Vision Fund, the largest investment fund in history to finance technology startups. He's got pledges from Apple's Tim Cook, Qualcomm, Foxconn, and one unexpected place. The Middle East.
Well, what's interesting is that the main backer of the fund is the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia, who contributed $45 billion.
45 minutes, $45 billion. $1 billion per minute.
Not all investors are on board with this vision. They point to SoftBank stock in Alibaba and other assets, which are worth more than 19 trillion yen. But SoftBank's market cap is only 9.8 trillion yen.
That's just evidence that a lot of investors are not buying Son's future.
Critics not only don't believe Son can pick the next Alibaba, they're convinced he's going to squander what he already has. Whether a believer or not in Musk's strategy, the investments he's making now are not like those he made during the 90s dot-com bubble. They are companies which have already proven they can survive.
In the end, whether Son deserves to be called a genius investor rather than just one with very deep pockets will probably depend on his ability to not just deliver a decent return, but also the kind of societal impact that he aspires to.